Tupac, do you never ever get road rage at all?
No. What is that?
You know, when you get mad on the road, someone who's like, who cuts you off or doesn't signal.
Such a waste of energy, right?
Is there a mantra that you recommend to center?
The simpler thing would be turn on the radio and listen to Mozart or something like that, you know, some great music that you enjoy. I think there's nothing like music to throw you into an expanded state of awareness.
Thanks.
I hate how unpredictable traffic in LA can be. Any given day I can be driving and, you know, a certain route can take me 30 minutes and the next day it can take me an hour. And it's so, like, I wish I could learn.
You should ask yourself, in 10 years, will this situation have changed my life?
So you're saying I can't, you know, I can't pretend like I'm so self-important that my ailments
are heavy
and worth stressing
over. All our misery comes from our self-importance.
Dang.
All our suffering comes from our self-importance, which is another way of... referring to the ego.
So let me get this right. So if I'm driving and someone cuts me off and I'm like,
feel your body.
You know?
Yeah. Instead of that, feel your body. Become aware of the sensations in your body and your attention will shift from the thought, which might be, screw this guy, or, you know, who the hell does he think he is?
Or I want to hit him with my car.
How do we dedicate ourselves to a practice when, like, every day is bombarded with so much chaos and there always seems like one more thing to do?
You can't be thinking about it as a chore. You know, you don't think about not brushing your teeth or going to the bathroom or taking a shower or having breakfast. So it's just like that. It becomes a part of your routine. First you get into the habit of, you know, breaking the link between the thought and the sensation. But secondly, you also have an insight after a while that the only person who's getting hurt is yourself. Mm-hmm. If you're waiting for other people to change so you can feel better, you'll wait a long time.
That's very true. I like that. Ooh. That's very true.
Now that I'm feeling happier, mm-hmm. That new fear has come up that, oh no, if I'm content, then I won't be driven.
I don't actually believe in hard work, discipline and driving ambition. I think that's the last refuge of the failure.
Coming from a man who's written like 9 New York Times selling.
20, by the way, and I'm not counting. Okay. But that's not the thing. That was never because of ambition. Or maybe it was 20 years ago, 25 years ago. But I believe that, I really believe in the law of least effort. Do less and accomplish more, and do nothing and accomplish everything in the end.